Which is the most hardest element to produce, for example?
I mean, from the elements that we know, the hardest one in the sense of the longest time to produce one atom was the element 113, because there you had about 3 atoms in 550 something days, yeah, and this is by far the lowest number so far, yeah.
Hello everyone, in this video I am going to tell you about the most expensive metal on earth, about Nihonium, 1 gram of which would cost more than all the elements on the earth, sold in the intergalactic market. If to be precise, the price is $15.7 sextillion. As all other superheavy transuranium elements, Nihonium is not found on the Earth. In our universe, it can only exist for a brief moment when a synthesis of all atoms heavier than iron takes place as a result of explosions of supernovas or in binary systems between neutron stars and black holes. On Earth, however, as well as all elements heavier than plutonium, is synthesized artificially. However, as the atomic number and mass of the new element grow, it gets harder to run a nuclear fusion with it, because nuclear strong force holding protons and neutrons together weakens, and as a result Coulomb repelling force grows. Discovery of the element 113 dates back in the 90s, when a team of research scientists from the Helmholtz University tried to synthesize this element in 1998 by bombarding bismuth target 208 with zinc 70 atoms, accelerated to 1/10 the speed of light. These attempts, however, were not very successful. After the initial failure of the German scientists, their American colleagues, along with Russian scientists from the town of Dubna, picked up on the experiment. This time, they chose americium 243 as their target, which was bombarded by calcium 48 atoms, which has a so-called double magic number of protons and neutrons. As a result of this nuclear fusion, they obtained an atom of element 115, after alpha decay of which, they obtained an atom of element 113. To prove the existence of element 114, it had to be obtained in a pure form, rather than as decay product of heavier element. That is what Japanese scientists tried to do, repeating the 1998 experiment by synthesizing element 113 from bismuth and zinc, even though the resultant product of the reaction was extremely small. Probability of obtaining a new element as a result of collision of zinc and bismuth atoms was practically negligible. The Japanese scientists, however, were remarkably patient. To obtain just one atom of Nihonium, the Japanese had to wait 10 months, all the while running the accelerator and all its systems around the clock. After that, in 2004, they confirmed that they obtained a new element. The obtained isotope Nihonium 278 had just a 1.4 millisecond long half-life. The new element was detected by the byproducts of its decay. There were 4 of them, and the last one was the spontaneous fission of dubnium. Do not forget that 1 hour of running a particle accelerator cost more than $1,000. That is why one atom of the element 113 costs about $7.5 million. Michael Block, a scientist in the GSI, will explain why it is so hard to produce Nihonium.
I mean, this is a matter of the nuclear reaction. It just happens that the nuclear reaction that you have to use for the production of this element has a very low probability of creating the compound system that you want. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of factors that go into whether this reaction has a certain probability to occur. I mean, it's a mix of the energy, of the stability of the nucleus you create against fission, and various parameters. Yeah, so I mean, it's not easy to predict, but I mean, some reactions are likely to be more effective than others. Yeah.
No matter how patient the Japanese scientists were, their experiment had to be repeated by other scientists in other accelerators. However, in 10 years no one managed to repeat the reaction of zinc with bismuth, not in Berkeley or in Dubna, neither in Darmstadt. The element 114 was created only as a result of decaying of elements 115 and 117. During that time, the Japanese managed to create another item of nihonium using bismuth and zinc just in 415 days of irradiation of bismuth foil with a stream of zinc atoms. No one has managed to repeat this experiment as well. Thus, if to calculate, 1 gram of nihonium costs about $45 octillion. Even if the entire Earth and Moon were sold, the money obtained from the sale will not be enough to buy it. In the end of 2015, EOPAC recognized discovery of the new element by the Japanese scientists. In 2016, the element 113 was named Nihonium after the word Nihon, which is one of the common Japanese names for Japan. During the entire research, the Japanese scientists have managed to create only 3 atoms of Nihonium 278. That is why it is extremely tricky to run chemical or physical experiments with this element. However, as it is common in case of studying of new elements, the scientists use computer modeling, which revealed that nihonium is supposed to be an inert metal similar to palladium or ruthenium. Its density should be 18 grams per square centimeter. However, I think you understand that nihonium as well as other superheavy elements is impossible to obtain in large quantities because of strong radiation. That is why even if you had a piece of nihonium, it would immediately evaporate because of self-heating during radioactive decay, releasing dangerous radioactive isotopes. Scientists, however, have managed to run some chemical experiments with this expensive metal during the last 5 years. Aleksander Jakushev, a nuclear physicist and a worker at the GSI, is going to tell you about.
And we produce element 113 nihonium as daughter of element 115. So actually we radiate americium 243 target with 148 ions and produce moscovium with a mass 288. Moscovium has a half-life about 100 milliseconds and it decays rapidly inside our gas chamber, and nihonium has a half-life about 1 second. So in principle it is enough for chemistry. If nihonium would be as inert as pyrrolium, but obviously nihonium is more reactive because it has 1 unpaired electron, and of course almost every collision to the wall can give adsorption on the wall. It's why the chemical yield is much lower. So we attempted to lay the nihonium once. We had a 20 days experiment, but we detected no nihonium events in our chemistry detector. So now we will spend some time to optimize our system, and for the next year we have 1 month for the second attempt, and we hope it will be successful.
As you can see, experiments with the most expensive metal on Earth will continue to be carried out to reveal all the secrets of matter and make the way to the so-called Iceland of stability. Maybe in future videos I'll tell you about such an unusual island. If you like this small documentary, don't forget to put a thumbs up for this video and support the channel on Patreon to provide me an opportunity to make more such as documentary and unique videos.